Okay, so according to the manual, you're gonna remove this one, this A, which corresponds to this one here. So now I should be able to lift this. Oh, there we go. Yes. So that hose is too short to go down, so I brought it up. I'm using like a S-hook to keep that elevated. Now, where are the brake pads? I think these are the brake pads here. They look really worn out already. How that is protected there, that little plate. See, these notches completely gone in this one. This something is pulling out, I say. Same thing with this one. Worn out completely. Nothing left. Probably don't need to do it. You just need to move the boot. You need to move the boot down. Okay, I get it now. So there's a whole bunch of grease in this boot. Let's clean it off. Let's clean off the old grease. So this is my ceramic extreme brake parts lubricant. This is what the stuff looks like. You just apply generous amounts, copious amounts, all over. Okay. And then you just slide it back in. There we go. There we go. It's that same thing. Just, you know, well, that's a lot. All over. That's it. You don't have any issues. And it goes to try to pump the brakes. Okay. And then we just push it over. Come on. Push it. There we go. Push it over. All the way. There we go. And it's in. There we go. Pops off. Like that. And the other one left as well. So it's the black on the... It's the black on the back. The silver... Smaller piece on the outside and then the bigger piece on the inside. this was created December 22nd, 2020, so less than a month ago. And it says it's for the RAV4. SAID is 477-XA3 for the front, make Toyota, and the part number is 04465-42180. So that's the part number there. And we're gonna pop it open. These are the new brake pads. They seem to be the same on both sides. There's no difference you can apply. So that's the difference there. Huge difference. These are completely worn out. They're not the same. This one goes on the right, and this one goes on the left. So the next time you do the other side of the wheel, you wanna remember which side belonged to which side. So we just pop, this one was on the left. So I think it was like this, yeah. Pops there. Goes on. And similarly, this side looks like it goes this way. And it goes on that side. This needs to come off a bit more. There you go. We need to put these things back, much like that one is, onto the new brake pads. And this one is a bit unusual. It had two plates on it, whereas the other one only had one. So that's kind of interesting as well. First you slide it in, because this bracket gets in the way, so you gotta slide it in at an angle. And then you just pop it in like that. Same thing with this one. This one can probably just go in straight, to be honest. Huh. That's not going in. Oh, that one went in. Okay, that went in too. Okay, so that's what the brake pad, the new brake pads look like when they're on. This little clip I took off from the old brake pads and pop them on. Each brake pad has two layers of this sheet, metal sheeting that goes on the back. Same on the other brake pad. And now we're ready to pop the caliper back on, pump the brakes a little bit, see where the brake fluid is, and then put it on the wheel. As I squeeze this piston inwards, brake fluid on this end is going to rise. What we don't want is for it to rise out of the container. If that's the case, it gets really close, we'll get a turkey baster to suck some excess fluid out. But hopefully it doesn't come to that. It's there's perhaps a proper tool for doing such. Okay, so let's just push up against that. Push this down and then tighten it. You can see, I'm just going to start squeezing this piston back in. And it's going in, I think. It is. Going back in. Let's just check the fluid. The fluid has risen. It used to be at this line, which is the max, and it's come up to here now. So it's getting. Looking at the manual here for torque specifications, 2016 later models. For the front, we have 34 newton meters. So you just pop that one in, and when that pops out, that means it's reached the torque specified torque. Now, I just need space to put this on. There we go. So I'll keep going. So
it's reached it. So it's clicked, it's popped out. It's popped out there. Pop it back in. And I'll just do it one more time. Make sure that that first one wasn't like a false positive. Just go there, okay, it's done. And we do the same for the other one. Pop that one in. And just there we go. One more time. And that's it. Apply the brake a few times, push it. It did go down, but not by a whole lot. I suspect I'm going to have to. So sometimes you need both wrenches and socket when putting it on like this. Okay. And the same when you're using the torque wrench as well. Okay. Yes. So I've had to use the turkey baster to remove some of the excess brake fluid. You can see it's just coming right up to the top.